and I left without any money. And I guess I don't know whether I'm in debt or not, because it all came from my friends and family.
Well, there's the free life, ladies and gentlemen. Charlie Doane, I'm still, as I listen to this, I'm still trying to key into the sailing community and their vividly mixed feelings about Reid Stowe. Take us back into that conversation. I mean, this is more than just whether he stayed out too long or not. Somehow Reid provokes, I mean, admiration and the opposite. And I wonder if you can take us into that a little more, Charlie. Why is that? What is it about this guy that provokes sailors in such diverse ways?
Well, I should say first that the people who've really been actively anti-Reid are a fairly small group, and their online focus has been an active sailboat racing website. They tend to be sailboat racers. Race sailing for them is a competitive sport. It's about speed. It's about performance. And Reid obviously is about none of that.
They can't stand the thought of a guy just kind of dawdling along around the planet. That bugs them for some reason.
Well, exactly. You know, the idea of sailing slow is totally alien to them, and the idea of just being out there to be out there is apparently alien to them. And one of the things I think goes on with this particular group is that they're all anonymous on the internet, and they express opinions more strongly and in more negative terms than they would if we were talking to them face to face, I think.
Yeah, that's something we've all learned.
A lot of people I've spoken to in the sailing community, I tell them, because I know this guy, Reid Stowe, he's planning to stay at sea for over 1,000 days, and they shrug their shoulders and go, huh? And they just don't get it, and it doesn't inspire any animosity or admiration. They're just basically confused by it. And then there are another group of people who get it, people who see sailing as something more than just a competitive sport, as a way of life and a way to communicate and commune with the largest environmental feature on our planet, a world where everything is liquid and vapor and the only solid thing is you and the boat you're on. People who are amazed and appreciate sailing on that level definitely appreciate Reid Stowe.